I'm proud to present another amp dyno video of a classic Rockford Fosgate amplifier. This time I have a Power 500.2 on the bench, which is rated 125 watts of continuous power into a 4 ohm load and 250 watts of continuous power into a 2 ohm load. After the first check, I found out that someone else already repaired this amplifier. You can see three output transistors have been changed and also the source resistors. But this guy was kind of lazy. You can see the power LED of the amplifier is just clipped on some components of the mainboard. I just corrected the position of the power LED, and you have to put the wires from the power LED through this small hole here. I didn't do a very detailed dyno video. I just tested with 1 kHz continuous and 1 kHz dynamic power, because this amplifier is very similar to different types I already tested. What is the difference between the Punch 500.2 and the Power 500.2? It's not the output power, it's just the power series has bigger power connectors and the slope of the filters is 24 dB instead of 12 dB. Here you have the RCA input, the gains for each channel, the Punch bass remote jack, you have a high pass full frequency spectrum and low pass switch. And this video is also subscriber supported. Thank you very much for sending this amplifier to my bench.
The Power 500.2 is connected to the dummy load and I'm starting with 8 ohms mono. That means I am testing 4 ohms per channel, both channels driven. And here you can check the idle current. It shows 1.6 amps. Continuous power test into a 4 ohm load with 1 kHz. Oops. 79.2 volts. The amplifier delivers 201 watt of continuous power into a 4 ohm load, both channels driven. Now I'm doing the dynamic power test with 20 cycles and a frequency of 1 kHz. It shows a maximum voltage of 82.8 volts, 219.8 watts. Now I'm doing the dynamic power test with just 8 cycles. Let's take 85.2 volts. The amplifier delivers an output power of 232.7 watts. Now I'm testing with just one cycle. And we have a peak voltage of 88.8 volts. The amplifier delivers 252.8 watts for just 1 millisecond with 1 kHz into a 4 ohm load. It pulls 41.7 amps. If I take the continuous power output, I have an efficiency calculated of 70.9%, which is impressive. And if I take the dynamic power, the amplifier has an efficiency of 77.5%. And now the amplifier is connected to a 4 ohm mono load. That means I test 2 ohms per channel, both channels driven. Continuous power test, 1 kHz. Oops. And I go to the top. Let's say 67.2 volts. The amplifier delivers 289.5 watts into a 2 ohm load per channel, both channels driven. Dynamic power test with 20 cycles. We have the first one, the first cycles are higher. So we have a peak voltage of 76.2 volts, and the last one is 72 volts. The highest cycle wasn't 76.2 volts, it was 72.6 volts, and the lowest cycle was 71.4 volts. That means the amplifier delivers a dynamic output power of 326 to 338 watts into a 2 ohm load per channel, both channels driven. Let's have a look at the amplifier's efficiency. 2 ohms. Wow, 71.4 amps. The amplifier has an efficiency of 60% if measured with continuous power test, and with dynamic power test, the amplifier has an efficiency of 68.8%. This is a value you find in your birth certificates of the old school Punch amplifiers. They use the dynamic power. Dynamic power test with 8 cycles. single shot with a maximum voltage of 79.2 volts. But I use the last cycle, the lowest cycle, 76.2 volts. The amplifier delivers 372.3 watts into a 2 ohm load if I use an 8 millisecond burst test signal with 1 kHz. Just for demonstration, I show you the difference between the amplifier's current consumption if I use a continuous power signal, and in the continuous power test, I had more than 70 amps of current the amplifier needed. So now I use a 8 millisecond burst power test, which simulates a crest factor. This comes close to music signal, which also has a higher crest factor. There will be less load to the amplifier's power supply. And now I give signal and you will see we are way lower than 70 amps. Oh, we just pulled 22 amps out of the power supply. So that means the amplifier generates less heat with a dynamic burst signal test, peak RMS power with 1 kHz and one cycle. That means output power for just 1 millisecond. And it shows 86.4 volts.
I hope you enjoyed the video, and if you like it, leave a thumb or subscribe to my channel. And if you subscribed, just hit the bell button to get information about the next video I'm publishing in the future. Thank you very much for watching and see you next time on another amp dyno video. Bye bye.